Serato DJ Pro has a great number of DJ effects. The DJ effects are powered by iZotope. When you purchase a Serato DJ license, you'll receive the base pack effects for free, and you can use these for your DJ sets and mixes. Some of the DJ effects that come with the base pack include echo, high pass and low pass filter, delay, and reverb. Additional DJ effects such as the wolf pack, the backpack, the jet pack, and the chip pack are available to purchase as expansion packs via the Serato website or in the app when you go to My Serato. You can use DJ effects in either single mode or multi-mode. Either mode can be assigned to any playing deck inside a Serato DJ Pro. Here, I'm using the Roland DJ-505 controller and will demonstrate how to use the single and multi-effect modes. In multi-effect mode, you can select up to 3 effects per effect unit and adjust one parameter, the effect depth. The effects are chained. One effect feeds into the next, allowing you to create unique combinations of effects. In the screen above the left playing deck is the effect button. When you press that, your effects will drop underneath your playing decks. Also on the screen, in the DJ effects section underneath the playing deck, you can click the multi-effect mode symbol, which has 3 dots in a line. You can click on the DJ effects select per slot and choose an effect to load. Using the DJ-505 controller, above each playing deck is the DJ effects section. You can select the multi-effect mode on the controller by holding Shift and Tap. So here on the DJ-505, if I hold down Shift and I press Tap, that will allow me to choose the effect mode that I want to use. The first one I'm going to choose is multi-effect. Multi-effect has 3 dots in a row. So here on the DJ-505, if I want to choose an effect for the effect slot inside the multi-effect, I'll hold down Shift and press the effect select button. As I do that, now I can continue to press it and go down until I find the effect that I want. And when I let go, the effect loads in. I just chose the clean echo out, but I'm gonna change that back to a high pass filter. I'm gonna do that actually in the screen by clicking in that slot and then scrolling back up until I get to high pass filter, and I'll click it to work. If I wanna turn on the effect, I can do that either in the screen or on the controller. To do it on the controller, I'll press the on button for that slot, and now that effect is activated. But now I can add the amount of the effect that I want to be on the song by turning the knob above. If I want to turn off the effect, I'll press the on button again, and the effect will be off. To turn on the effect slot in the multi-effects mode on the DJ-505, you can press the DJ effect enable button. The button will light up to indicate that it's on. Once the effect is on, you can turn the DJ effect parameter knob in the slot to adjust the amount of the effect. It's possible to have 3 effects on at the same time in multi-effect mode. The effects are chained, so one effect feeds into the next. This combination will allow you to create a great group of DJ effects. So here, I have 3 effects selected in multi-effect mode. I'm going to use these effects to make some variations in the song that's playing. So in the screen, next to the beat multiplier, I can choose where I want the effect to be assigned to for the channel. I have a multi-effect assigned to channel 1 right now, but I could assign it to channel 2, 3, 4, or aux. Aux in this case, because I'm using the DJ-505 controller, is being routed to the TR and sampler level. This controller is really great because it has a drum machine built inside. So if I want the effects to go to the drum machine, I can route it to aux, and then that will go to that channel. So if you want to do that here on the DJ-505, you can go next to the effects section, and there you'll find the channel assigned. You can choose channel 1, channel 2, channel 3 if you hold down Shift, channel 4 if you hold down Shift, and also the TR sampler. If you press TR sampler, it will send the effects to either the drum machine or the sampler to be affected. So let's talk about single effect mode. In single effect mode, you can select one effect per effect unit and can adjust multiple parameters within it. So I'm going to change this from multi-effect to single effect by holding down Shift and pressing effect mode. Here in the screen is now changed it to a single effect. Remember, a single effect has 1 dot next to it instead of 3 dots in a row. If I want to choose an effect to work with in single effect mode, I'll hold down Shift and press on any of the effect select buttons until I get to an effect that I want to use. To turn on the effect in the slot for the single effect mode on the DJ 505, you can press the DJ effect enable button. The button will light up to indicate that it's on. Once the effect is on, you can turn the first DJ effect parameter knob for the slot to adjust the amount of the DJ effect. The additional DJ effect parameter knobs can be used for secondary parameters in the DJ effect. The additional DJ effect enable buttons can be used to turn on secondary parameters. Each DJ effect has its own specialized secondary parameters that can be turned on and adjusted from the controller. So a couple great reasons to use effects. Effects are great for adding color and sonic emotion to a track or a mix. A great DJ effect is the echo out. When this effect is activated, it will cut the volume at the section of the song that is selected, and it'll also add an echo with the high pass filter. So here on the DJ 505, I'm gonna have a track playing on deck one. I'm also going to have a drum pattern that I've created playing from the TR on the drum machine. That's gonna be synced up to the track that's playing. On this track, I'm going to use the break echo effect to stop this track. And then while the drum machine is playing, I'm gonna use a clean echo out. So that's how you use DJ effects in Serato DJ Pro. For more information, log on to Serato.com.